Now, in Broadway, on Broadway, when, you know, we've been talking about musicals, you would say that if the Clippers were a Broadway show, right, Kawhi Leonard would be above the title on the poster. Like Nathan Lane in, right?
I always think of him in the same
vein. But you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, of course.
Lin-Manuel Miranda, okay? It would be above Hamilton.
Mm-hmm.
So in Broadway, or on Broadway, if the guy above the title on the poster has to take the night off because he's sick, they have to offer you your money back. Now, if it's somebody underneath the title, then you don't get your money back. But if Nathan Lane is not performing in the front page, right, a play that he was in,
right,
then you get your money back. Or you could sit there and watch it, but you have the option of getting your money back. I don't understand how Kawhi Leonard misses the Milwaukee Buck game and you don't have the option of getting your money back.
It's no longer the marquee matchup. You know what the line is?
No.
Bucks are favored by 6.5. It shouldn't be. The game's in Los Angeles.
And imagine you're going to take off a home game and play against Portland instead.
But it's,
I would think any kind of load management, it should be, you should do right by your fan base and give him load management off games when he's on the road. It hurts those people out of buying tickets to see Kawhi.
Then there's that part.
Yep. I mean, I don't think there's any easy way here.
Well, because it's the only sport where the players are more important than the teams they play on. As big as Tom Brady is, Michael, is he bigger than the entire Patriot organization?
No.
Heck, they went 11-5 one year without him, right? It's the only sport like this. As good as Aaron Judge is he bigger than the Yankees? No, he's not. But in the NBA, these players are bigger than the teams that they play on. The reason that Cleveland becomes important is because, for a time, LeBron James played there. And then they become unimportant once LeBron James leaves. So it's the only sport where the franchises really don't matter. It's about the players.
When they talk about the unbreakable records, the unbreakable record now is Cal Ripken Jr.'s consecutive game streak. Because no team now, because even baseball is obsessed with load management. They just don't call it that. They give a guy off once a week. There's no way any team will allow a player to play that many games in a row because they have done statistical analysis with doctors and they say that you're more effective if you have time off. But there is a paying public and there are national broadcasting companies that are paying big money to broadcast these games. And I will tell you that the ratings for the Bucks against the Clippers tonight will take a huge hit because Kawhi Leonard's not playing.
But because there are so many games in baseball, Michael, even if you took 20 games off, you could still strategically put those days off where nobody's going to care that you took it off.
Mm-hmm.
With the Mets and Pete Alonso, all right, first of all, he only missed, what, one game last year, so obviously there was no load management for him. But I'm sure the Mets would not do it if there were the game of the week on Saturday or if Sunday night baseball, he'd play. You could strategically, you know, second game of a doubleheader, day game after a night game, the afternoon game against the Padres at Citi Field on a Wednesday. You could do it and nobody's going to notice. But when you do it on national television, it doesn't happen. It doesn't happen in any other sport.
It's almost like the Clippers are spitting in the face of the NBA. Yeah,
well, the Clippers
play against the Bucks.
But it's the Clippers because the Clippers are going to be able to tell their player.
Think the Clippers are the ones that map out the load management.
But they do and it now, because the player wants it.
But he needs a certain amount of days off. Woj tweeted out that the NBA said, well, he is on the injured list because his knee is hurting him, so this is a legitimate night off. Really? Then why is he playing tomorrow? Is he going to go take a dip in the Fountain of Youth? He knows he could play tomorrow, but he can't play tonight against the Bucks.
So if you there's a problem. How do you fix it? Well, you either convince the player to play more, convince them to only take off days that aren't nationally televised, or do you try to put situations like where you've got back-to-back nationally televised games? You don't do that.
You don't
schedule it that way.
I don't understand why LeBron could play every single game, but Kawhi Leonard can't.
It's just
how many days off does Antetokounmpo get?
Nothing, I don't think. I think last year he played almost everything, but that's who Kawhi is. I don't think he cares. I think that maybe he's not as obsessive a competitor as LeBron James is. LeBron doesn't like the idea of losing any game, missing any time. Maybe Kawhi Leonard knows where his bread is buttered in the playoffs. He'll be there for that. He'll win a championship, and that's that.